Hi guys, how are you guys doing? So I feel really awkward doing this because obviously I've never done this before. If you've been watching my channel for a while, you know that this is the first time ever that I'm showing my face, which is like mind-blowing to me. I didn't expect that I would ever do this. I hope I look cute afterwards though. I wanted to cover a couple of things before I dive into this video. First of all, obviously, you can see my face now. I hope that makes you happy, but if it doesn't, sounds like a personal problem to me. I've had so many people reach out to me recently. My friends, family, everybody, my co-workers. I know you guys were watching. To be honest, I've been so busy. If you're a young adult watching this video in your early 20s, listen, enjoy it while you can because it gets tough. Adulting basically sucks. That's it. That's the tweet. If you're like me, you have many questions about why my face is here. Like, what is this girl doing? I swore I would never, ever, 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 ever show my face. I was like, nah, G, I'm just about the craft. I'm about the art. I'm about the fashion. I lied, y'all, because here I am. I know I started out as a DIY channel, and obviously that's still what I am, but I would also like to venture more into the fashion world. So basically, I'll be bringing some affordable fashion hauls for you. I very rarely do expensive, even though technically I can afford expensive now. I just very rarely do it. Wait, is this thing recording? Oh, it is. Okay. Sorry, I had to check that real quick. I'm also going to be changing up my narration style to those of you that have been following me for a while. You know I'm very 1 plus 1 equals 2. But I feel like those of you who follow me are incredibly smart and incredibly, you know, knowledgeable and quick to catch information that you don't need me feeding it to you. So I'm going to change it up a little bit and we're going to speed it up a bit, basically. So no more, now you put the thread into the needle and then you pull it through and then you tie it. That's done. We're moving on to better, bigger, more mature things, okay? DIY and fashion, and honestly, I just need the flexibility to be able to do both because having to do DIYs every week was becoming quite strenuous for me, and I do have other passions that I'm focusing on. In fact, this is just more of a fun thing for me versus like my actual passion. So I've just gotten to a point in my life where I'm like, you know what, I need to focus. So yeah, you know. Oh, by the way, President Trump also has coronavirus. I'm also trying to be more organized with my videos and my recordings, so when you see me looking down on my phone, I'm actually just going through my notes. Okay, so now that I've covered all of that so that you guys are in the know and you're aware of what's happening in my life, let's just move on to this tutorial. So in today's video, I'm trying to transform 2 shirts. It might change down the line. Let's go. So the first shirt I'm gonna transform is this orange shirt that I bought from Value Village. Yes, I love this color. I don't know why, it just like gives me great vibes. I'm just loving it. We're gonna make a dress out of this or a two-piece, I don't know yet, but let's just get into it. So I'm gonna cut from right here, make it slightly fitted, and then make a cute dress out of it. Are you excited? Because I am! I got rid of the pocket because we don't need that. Then I measured just above the bust, divided that by 2, added 1 inch seam allowance to both sides, and marked it from the midline. You should also make sure that the midpoint of your measurement is at the midpoint of the shirt. Then I measured the length I wanted for my top and marked that on my top as well. Then measured around my waist, divided that measurement by 2, and added 1 inch seam allowance on both sides and marked it from the middle. The whole time again, you want the midpoint of both measurements at the middle of the shirt. When this was done, I joined the top to the bottom on both sides and cut it all around. When I got to the neck area, I had to be super careful here. I'm going for a very specific style, so I cut around the collar and the buttons, making sure that I don't touch the buttons or the buttonhole area, and also leaving some seam allowance around it as well. So I'm just cutting around my shirt here and cutting around the collar, as you can see. And once that's all done, I pin down the sides on both sides. I got carried away and I sort of messed up at the back area here. I wanted it to be equal, but I'm still gonna make it work. I'm just gonna go ahead and double fold it, sew it down, and you know, move on with my life.
So really, what I should have done with this is I should have left some seam allowance around this collar so that I can fold this over and cover that white behind. That way it's just like a seamless look at the back of the shirt. But I didn't do that because I'm obviously super slow. Right now it's all tucked in behind the white strip thing, so with this side you can kind of see the white strip I'm talking about here, which would have been nice to cover if I had left out enough, but I didn't, so boo.
So I need to recap on what I did. I single folded ish across the collar. I went all around, sew that down all the way around the shirt until here, and then all the way around again.
Some things to note if you're ever going to try this is, number one, always leave enough room for seam allowance. So I did half an inch even on the sides, and that was still not enough. This area had only half an inch, so I wasn't even able to double fold with half an inch. And maybe you can double fold if you're like a super professional that can use half an inch to double fold, but I really struggled. So what I would suggest is leaving 1 inch seam allowance on each side. Also, when you're cutting this area as well, take into account seam allowance. Again, 1 inch this side, leave as much so that you can fold it over neatly and even double fold it underneath. Right now I have like a really ratchet looking work, but it doesn't look so bad. So I'm going to close the sides, single fold at the bottom, and then we can call it a day for the top part. Ugh, I'm so tired, y'all.
If you think this bottom part will be really difficult for you, you can single fold it over first and pin it down first before you begin sewing. Though I decided not to do that because I was just going to fold and sew as I go.
Okay, humans, so the top is all ready. I did a fake serge at the edge of my sides because I don't have a serger, but if you have one, you might be better off using it because this was kind of a whack job, if I'm being honest. So now that the top is done, we can move on to the bottom. I'm thinking I should make a skirt. I was going to make a dress. I don't know how I forgot that I wanted to make a dress and somehow just made a complete top. For the bottom, this is all I have left, which is like obviously ridiculous for a skirt. I mean, it would be too short even if I tried. So I'm going to try to add some length to this situation. What's my problem? I think I have an idea. Yeah, let's try it. What we're finna do is make some extra length from these scrap materials. So I'm just gonna go into cut in. It's pretty straightforward. I just want to add extra length here and extra length at the top as well.
So basically what I'm doing is using what's left of my shirt to cut out 4-inch wide scrap pieces. There's no real method to this, seeing as I'm pretty much just going where the wind takes me, but you essentially want your scrap pieces to be 4 inches each so that they're all equally wide, even though they probably won't be the same length. It'll take you a minute or two to execute this, but you'll get there, don't worry. I hope this makes sense.
Okay, that was tedious. I would not wish that on my worst enemy. But I do have a bunch of scraps right now, so I'm basically going to join them together and try to form 2 layers of length to add to this. Oh, what to do when it's getting dark and you don't have a light. So I've sewn some strips together to give me this long strip. I'm going to do another one just like this as well, and then bring the ends together to meet. And I've also checked this with my other bottom and they're the same length or whatever, so I think I'm on the right path basically. So I'm just going to do this twice.
Nighttime is approaching, but my strips are ready and sewn together in bands so that I can attach them to my skirt.
So you want to make sure that while you're joining your bands, the front side is facing the front side of the other. I sew the bands together first, and when I'm done, I join it with the rest of my shirt and I sew it together again, front side facing front side.
Good morning. So our skirt's done, thank God. I just need to fold this once to fit an elastic band, and I think I'm all done. This one, you know, the snugness. Cut it. So this is going to be my elastic band that I'm going to use. I closed the top of my skirt. I just folded it once and now I'm going to fold it again. And the reason why I folded it the one time is obviously to hide the frame. I pinned my tube down in preparation for sewing. You don't have to do this, but I suggest that you do. Honestly, it just makes it a whole lot easier to keep it equal all around. This is some premium ghetto sewing. Like, what? I mean, it works, you know? We're almost done. The only thing left to do now is to feed that elastic through the tube. And the tube is quite ready to go. As you can see, I sewed it all the way around, but I left a gap right here. So don't forget to leave a gap and don't forget to backstitch here.
You need the bobby pin connected to your elastic band and another bobby pin holding the other side of your elastic band down to your skirt so it doesn't drift into the tube as you feed it in. This part is pretty much the most straightforward part, to be honest. Just keep pushing that pin in like the pro that you are, and once you're done, bring it to me the other side and sew it down. Spread that elastic through so that it's all even in that tube. Do a quick victory dance because you made it and you're a star, and be careful not to hurt yourself in the process. Once you're all done, close that gap for the feeding tube and call it a day.
I feel like I need to take off my glasses because it's giving me like this really preppy schoolgirl look. Right off the bat, this is not my style at all. I don't. But I'm glad that I made this. At least I know, because I've been seeing the trends on Pinterest, on Instagram, and I kind of wondered about it, like what would it look like on me. I think the color is okay. I think it's just the style, to be honest. This is not for me at all. But some people might find this cute, I don't know. So it doesn't look bad paired with these pants from Pretty Little Things, but still not my vibe at all. Or even with like a skirt like this.
I just think it's not my vibe.
Thank you so much for watching. Subscribe, like, comment, show me some love. Thank you so much.